Hey guys, how y'all doing? I just wanted to give you a quick update based on a movie I saw coming out this weekend since I got to see an early screening for it, so figured might as well give a review for it.
Warm Bodies is a dark romantic comedy about a zombie who falls in love with a living girl. Sounds like a silly concept on paper, though a vampire that sparkles in the daytime isn't too far off, and look how well that's worked. However, when the Twilight Saga doesn't embrace a silly concept, Warm Bodies does, making it the better film. The movie's based on a book by the same name by the author Isaac Marion. Our hero is a zombie named R. He lives in an abandoned airport with other zombies who can barely communicate with each other. It leads to a neat scene where our hero imagines what each corpse's lives were like before being turned into zombies. One day as he's hunting for prey, R becomes smitten after meeting a human girl named Julie, one of the film's subtle attempts at drawing a Romeo and Juliet parallel. He takes her to his den by covering Julie's smell to keep other zombies from noticing. This leads to a growing romance, a misunderstanding, and even results in R going back to Julie's place, meeting up with her belligerent zombie-hunting father, played by the articulate John Malkovich. One very important detail is that as R and Julie fall further in love, he becomes more alive, reversing his zombified state. This is one of those details that can make or break the film for people. I think as far as modern monster movies go, moviegoers have bred themselves for logical reasoning. Most other zombie films would have a made-up scientific reason for why zombies are springing forward. In both the movie and book, there's never a reason as to why the zombie outbreak has started, though with the tone of the film, it never makes it the focus. When I first read the book in preparation for the film, I felt that it was the type of movie Tim Burton would have directed earlier in his career, where it's fueled on emotional reasoning as opposed to logical reasoning, hence why things happen based on how the audience feels versus how it should happen, logically. One of the strengths of the film is that the zombies themselves are given quirks and traits that make them fun characters to watch on screen, since pop culture likes to embrace zombies as rampant beasts who are, no offense, dumb creatures. Some of my favorite zombies tend to be the sympathetic characters. The zombies probably didn't wish to be made the way they are. Last year, Paranorman was one of my favorite films for having these type of zombies. Our hero R has dreams, ambitions, and motivations that are made easy for the audience to empathize with. It also contributes to a well-timed voiceover of R's thoughts. This is where most of the comedy came from. My only regret is that I wish it didn't have an inner monologue for the whole film. This I can understand because this is how the character narrated the story from the book.
I wish I could introduce myself, but I am dead. It's kind of a bummer.
However, in a visual medium like film, it's better that the movie shows us rather than tells us. This is what I liked it best when actor Nicholas Hoult would rely on expressions and gestures to communicate, much like Johnny Depp and Edward Scissorhands. Though as far as the performance goes, it was still good and made him one of the stronger characters in the film. Though not all the zombies are good guys. In one of the film's few departures from the book, the Bonies are the zombies minus the flesh that have been decomposing longer, thus making them the wiser authority figures among the more fresh corpses. I didn't think the CG looked terrible. For me, it served its purpose, making these animated models into believable and threatening characters. And now I may be nitpicking, but one of the things that does keep this film from being one of my all-time favorite rom-coms is the plot. Oddly enough, the movie stays very faithful to the source material. However, there are a few things that change that would make more sense in a visual medium versus a literary one. It also turns something genuine into a contrived plot point. While I won't spoil what it was, it involves Julie's ex-boyfriend and a misunderstanding between her and R. Having the misunderstanding like this happens in so many films that we know by the end they'll be making up for it. It didn't happen like this in the book, and I wish it could have stayed that way. But again, time restraints most likely kept it from happening that way.
In short, I feel that Warm Bodies is a pretty good date film. I think the girls would like the romance and the guys would like the blood and gore. I give it a B.